I'm Sarah Johnson. This is my service quilt about service philosophy. Good service philosophy is all of these things. I put you need enthusiasm. You need enthusiasm, positivity, humbleness, understanding, respect, and ready to learn, knowing your product slash job, and service recovery, being able to recover from any incident that you may have to if anything fails. The first thing I'm going to talk about is enthusiasm. The flower represents basically a good business, how you should be run without the petals, without any of this. No one's going to want to buy it, no one will pay attention, and they had a horrible experience. A not so good for service philosophy was basically having these sunflowers with no petals out, so no one would want to buy them. Enthusiasm, you have to love what you do. If you don't, fake it. People don't know what you're going through. Just put a smile on your face and they will react to that. So, and if you don't have enthusiasm, you just lost part of your flower. Non-service philosophy of no enthusiasm means your employees don't like your job and everyone else that comes visit your job or your place of work will not want to come back. It is a bad example to set on either side. The next one I have, positivity. Positivity means you need to just be positive in everything you do. Guests can feel what you feel. If you're not positive about things, they'll receive that in a negative way. If you're negative, they'll be negative, and it won't be a good interaction between your guests. Example, if I worked at a garden and I only had no sunflowers and one sunflower was just dead, it just looks bad on me. And if I'm not positive about it, trying to find them other flowers or do other things, then it's just not going to look good on my part. Humbleness. No matter how tough it is, humbleness always wins. And without humbleness, you will not get by, because there's always going to be people you don't get along with. And once that happens, if you're not humble or positive, that will affect your business, your employees, and everything around you. So my next word is understanding. You need to have understanding of guest complaints. You have to understand what's coming from their situation. I've had guests complain to me, and all you have to do is agree to them, agree to whatever they're complaining about, and try to find a solution. And that way everyone wins, and you have a guest leaving the store happy. Any concerns, you have to just be understanding of everything. If you're not understanding, then they're not going to come back. They'll tell other people not to come back, and your business just lost a customer. So understand where they're coming from, and most likely you can solve the problem of what they're having. But if you can't, that's just another petal that you lost. RTL, ready to learn. It's just basically you learn something new every day. No day is the same. You're very naive as an employee, manager, etc., of any part of the business you're running or working for if you don't think that there's something to learn every day. There's something to learn from the guests. There's something to learn from your other employees. Everything comes into play. And if you're ready to learn, that means you're positive and ready to go every single day and looking forward to everything that comes your way. And knowing your job, knowing your product. An example of this is if you go up to someone in a grocery store and they're in the meat department and you ask something about the meat and they don't know, it reflects on you. You don't know what you're doing, then why, you know, it just doesn't make any sense. I ask you, you're a stock person, I ask you where something is, you don't know where it is, well, how do you not know where the milk is? when you stock it. It's just knowing your job makes you look better as a person, makes you feel better that you know what you're doing and more confident in yourself. If you know your job well, then you can, everything else comes easy. So that's all that. And then the last one is service recovery. This one is very important because no one's ever going to be pleased all the time. And if they're not pleased, then you have to figure out how to recover from that. Service recovery. Well, this is a big one. This is my conclusion. To run a successful business or anything, you need to learn how to utilize all of these things I just said to please the guests in any which way you can. And if this is what I have to present, they're not going to want these flowers. They're not going to want any part of this. It's, you know, they're wilting, they're dead, or they have no petals. Who wants a flower with no petals? In conclusion, once you understand all of these concepts of this, and someone has a problem, say with a sunflower, you disregard this, understand them, be humble towards these people that don't like this sunflower. You want to be humble and understand what they're coming from and respect their opinion, because if you don't respect them, they won't respect you. You ought to be ready to learn, so this may teach you how to treat your sunflowers, your employees, your guests, whatever, and knowing your product will help this prevent for next time. So out of service recovery, and my conclusion is businesses are like sunflowers. You need to pay attention to all details in your business or else it will fail. And if you don't want a sunflower, you always can have a lovely orchid, which in actuality, overall hospitality in general is to make someone's day better, even if it's not what they wanted officially. Thank you.